And ahead of the storm, researchers at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography are launching weather balloons and aircrafts to study the incoming storm. Our Liberty Zabala joins us live from La Jolla with more on what they hope to learn about this atmospheric river ushering in this latest storm. Liberty.
Good evening, Kathleen, and we're already feeling sprinkles out here right now. Now, Scripps scientists are teaming up with NOAA and the U.S. Air Force Hurricane Hunters to fly straight into the storm. A bird's eye view from this C-130 aircraft, which will carry U.S. Air Force Hurricane Hunters into the storm before it makes landfall into San Diego.
Air Force Hurricane Hunters, who operate the C-130 jets, fly over atmospheric rivers in the Northeast Pacific, which we can see via satellite, but a lot of the intensity of the atmospheric river is in the water and the wind, the water vapor and the wind that is much closer to the surface and is difficult to see.
That's why Scripps Institution of Oceanography researchers at the Center for Western Weather and Water Extremes are teaming up with the Air Force and NOAA to send aircraft, people and instruments into the storm.
So we can really pinpoint how strong the atmospheric river is and then how much precipitation might result.
The Hurricane Hunters are expected to take flight from Sacramento Thursday. Meanwhile, the NOAA Gulfstream 4 will take off Friday to study the atmospheric river. Scripps researchers are also launching weather balloons in Northern California.
So those are going to give us profiles of temperature, moisture, and winds, and that's going to help us observe atmospheric rivers right as they're making landfall.
Researchers say collecting this weather data will improve forecasts and help give residents ample warning on the ground.
How much precipitation they'll bring and how long they will last is really critical, both for water resource management, but also for emergency response.
And Scripps researchers also say that these atmospheric rivers are responsible for most of California's water supply, but they're also responsible for nearly all of the hazardous flooding in the state as well. For now, live here in La Jolla, Liberty Zabala, Fox 5 News.